Hi dear learner, I welcome you again in the next lecture. Today I am going to discuss about the aerodynamic forces and moments acting on the aircraft. In the previous lecture, I have given you an idea about anatomy of aircraft, and also we have covered how lift is getting generated over the aircraft. Right. So there I have given you two definitions of lift based on circulation and based on the pressure difference. Right. Both of those definitions are correct, but most accurate definition is your circulation based equation. So here today we are going to see that how actually the lift is going to generate and what are the different forces acting on the aircraft and in what way they are going to influence the motion of the aircraft when aircraft is flying. As we see that the airflow moving on the aircraft or any object which is moving through the air, it will disturb the flow pattern of the air. Initially flow will be uniform. So if object is moving through the air domain, it will disturb the flow domain. What will happen that when air will deflect in direction from its original path, such kind of deflection leads to decrease in air velocity. And also, as per the Bernoulli's principle, we know that the pressure adjusted by the air on the surface of the object will be different than the pressure of the free stream air flow, right? Because we know that on the surface of the object, if object is fully streamlined like an airfoil where upper surfaces are having more curvature, in that case what will happen? At the top surface pressure will be less because velocity will be more and free stream pressure which is constant. So the chances are there that on top surface of the object pressure will be lesser than the free stream pressure. So both the pressure cannot be equal as per the Bernoulli's principle. And also due to the viscosity of air, there will be existence of frictional forces which will tend to resist the motion of the aircraft, or which would resist the motion of the airflow on the surface of the aircraft. As the result of these processes, the aircraft experiences net resultant aerodynamic force and moments on itself. Now, what are those aerodynamic forces and moment? Basically, over the surface of the wing, if we look at, there will be pressure forces, there will be skin friction forces, and because of viscosity of air, there will be side forces because wing is a finite, so it will have span. From tip of the wing, there will be some mixing of flow will take place from bottom surface to the top surface. So there will be side forces also acting on it. So there are variety kind of forces would be acting on the aircraft. Among these, four forces are considered to be the basic because they always act on the aircraft in all kind of maneuvers. These four forces are basically, if we want to characterize what are those basic four forces which always act on the aircraft when aircraft is flying, those are lift, weight, thrust and drag. So I will draw here schematically how actually those forces acts over the aircraft. So I'm drawing here one schematic diagram. So this is your aircraft which is flying. So this is your wing. And here horizontal stabilization. So let's suppose over the wing somehow I got center of pressure that also I will define later on. So at this point, my lift is acting. So lift is always acting perpendicular to the free stream. So free stream direction is like this. So this is my free stream flow which is having velocity v. If that flow is coming and perpendicular that, I got the lift and lift will support the weight of the aircraft, and aircraft makes some initial motion. That motion will be provided by the thrust generated by the engine. So engine will give the thrust which will propel the aircraft. So thrust, let's suppose it is also acting in this direction. This is thrust and opposing force is drag.
this is drag. So these are basically four forces, right, acting over the, this is center of pressure, right? So center of pressure is the fixed is a point on the chord line of the airfoil, right, at which the net resultant aerodynamic force is supposed to act, right? So net resultant aerodynamic force means it is a summation of lift and drag, which in turn will be acting at this point, this is center of pressure. So these are the basically four forces. So I can write here, four forces are, first is lift, second is weight will be due to gravity, right, due to gravity, weight, third one is thrust, fourth one is drag. So these are the four basic forces which will be acting over the aircraft in all kind of maneuver, right, whether it is flying horizontally or it's climbing or doing any kind of turning or any kind of aerobatic activities, these four forces would be acting always on the surface of the aircraft, right? So in a steady state, when I am saying it is a steady state flight, in a steady state flight, right, the altitude and direction as well as the speed of the aircraft will remain the same until one or more of these basic forces change in magnitude, right? If they are not changing, it will remain the same. Altitude, direction and flight velocity will remain the same in steady state flight. Right. If it is a steady level horizontal flight, if I say steady level horizontal flight, in that case, right, all the opposing forces will be in equilibrium. So lift will be exactly equal to the weight and thrust will be exactly equal to the drag. If that condition exists, my aircraft will be flying in steady horizontal flight or steady level flight. If I am saying this unaccelerated flight, that is also steady level flight. Unaccelerated flight, that means all forces are in equilibrium, that is unaccelerated flight. If it is accelerated flight, that means one or more of these forces will change and may become greater than the opposing forces. In that case, you will get accelerated flight. So for an example, right, if I am putting some pressure on the control panel or aircraft controls, because of that one of these forces altered and became greater than the opposing force. So consider the condition, if I want to maintain the same altitude, right, same altitude, right, and if I am increasing the thrust, all of a sudden I am increasing the thrust, then what will happen? What will happen then? Aircraft velocity will increase. So all of a sudden I am increasing the thrust while maintaining the same altitude and same angle of attack, my aircraft will accelerate. That will call as accelerated flight, right? So in accelerated flight, one or more of these forces may enter, may become greater than the opposing forces. Alright. So now one by one we will define what basically these basic forces are. So let's start with the lift. So first definition is lift. Lift is denoted by L always, right? So lift is the upward force created by the aircraft when flying through the air. This is general definition. Or in the way we can say, as a result of these forces, right, skin friction forces and because of the pressure difference, we get the resultant net resultant force acting over the aircraft, and one component of that net resultant aerodynamic force is called lift. So let's suppose this wing cross section is airfoil. So airfoil need to be kept at certain angle of attack to the free stream direction. So this is the free stream direction to which I am keeping, this is the chord line, and this is the free stream direction, this is known as angle of attack. Angle between the chord line and free stream direction is called angle of attack. So airfoil is specially designed shape which when capped at an appropriate angle and it is propelling, right, it's moving by a thrust generated from an engine, right, it generates a normal reaction, right, that is called a net resultant aerodynamic force. So normal reaction will be creating like this. So this is the net resultant aerodynamic force, and one component of this net resultant aerodynamic force will be called it. So vertical component of it, so this is a net resultant aerodynamic force. So vertical component of it, if I draw like this, so this is known as lift. So the component of
resultant around a force perpendicular to the free stream direction is called lift, right, which will support the weight of aircraft. Alright, so one component is like this, another component you will get here. So this is called drag. This is chord line, right? So that you can write chord line. So lift is the component of resultant aerodynamic force acting perpendicular to the direction of light or perpendicular to the free stream direction. Alright. And it will be generated based on the concept, right? At top surface pressure is less, at bottom surface pressure is more. As a result, that you will get the lift. You will get the lift. So lift is over. If we talk about the weight, second parameter is weight. What is happening due to gravity? So gravity is the force which tends to draw all the bodies toward the center of Earth. So aircraft center of gravity is the point at which total weight of aircraft is considered to be concentrated. So if I want to draw here CG position of an aircraft, so this is something structure which is hanging on aircraft here. So aircraft is hanged here, so this is the aircraft. So this is the airfoil and this is hanged over this point. And if this is remaining at horizontal direction like this, that means what? This point will be called as CG point, center of gravity. So center of gravity is the point, right, at which total weight of the aircraft is considered to be concentrated, right? So weight is basically due to the gravity. Atmospheric gravity is the weight. Next one, thrust. Thrust. So thrust will be generated by the engine. Now engine may be propeller driven or it will be a turbojet engine. So thrust is generated when we are expelling the high temperature gases, right, through the nozzle at very high speed. As per the Newton's third law of motion, we will get the momentary thrust generated. If we talk about the propeller, propellers are designed to push larger amount of mass flow rate of air, right, relative to higher speed. As a result of that, it gains the momentary thrust. So proper activation airfoil generate the thrust which will propel the aircraft right through the air. So the thrust, is generated by the engine basically. The thrust. And next one is drag. So drag is the resistant force, right, which will assess the motion of aircraft. Or drag is the penalty that we are paying for creating the lift on airfoil, right? So drag is the component of resultant aerodynamic force acting parallel to and in the same direction of undisturbed stream of air, or you can say it is the resistance force acting opposite to the flight direction. So if you look at here, so it is acting opposite to the flight direction. Flight is going in this direction, drag is acting opposite to the direction. Or if you look at it is a parallel to the free stream direction, right? So the movement flow is coming here, it will be undisturbed, and here it will be disturbed flow. The movement is leaving the aircraft, here it will be again undisturbed flow. So it will be parallel to and in the same direction of undisturbed flow. So this is drag. So these are the four basic forces those used to act on the aircraft, right? Now let's go, these are the four forces. Now let's see what are the moments. So four forces and moments, we'll have to look for what are the moments which act over the aircraft. So in anatomy of aircraft, I already mentioned you aircraft axis system. So we are having three axis system. That one is longitudinal axis. There is a imaginary line passing from the front, that is nose of the aircraft to the tail of the aircraft, and passing through the center of gravity. Such a line is known as a longitudinal axis. Second is called lateral axis. Lateral axis is the imaginary line connecting one wingtip to the another wingtip and passing through the CG. And this longitudinal and lateral both are at 90 degree. And the third one is called normal axis. Normal axis is the imaginary line, right, perpendicular to both lateral and longitudinal axis and passing through the CG. So we are having three axes, and along these three axes we are having three motions. So all those three motions will be controlled by three moments basically. So we are going to define now our three moments, how actually those look like. So I will draw here a schematic diagram of axis first. So this is your longitudinal axis, right? So this, let's suppose this is the my CG position. I can say this is CG position. So lateral axis will be 90 degree to it. So this is lateral axis. This is longitudinal axis, right? Now perpendicular to both of these axes, there will be third axis, that is called normal axis. So this is normal axis. So we can draw the aircraft here. So this aircraft is here, and over the aircraft we have drawn the axis, and this is the flight direction, right, with the velocity in the flight path. So perpendicular to the flight path there will be lift. So this is the normal axis along which lift will be acting. So lift will be acting over this, and drag will be acting over here. This is drag, right? So lift, drag we have presented over the diagram. Now there are three motions. As we see, rolling will happen about the longitudinal axis. This longitudinal axis, rolling will happen about the longitudinal axis, right? And about normal axis, this motion, this perpendicular axis, about the normal axis, this kind of motion. And this kind of motion is called yawing, right? And about lateral axis, this kind of motion, nose up and nose down, this will happen about lateral axis. This is called pitching. So three motions, and these will be controlled by three moments, right? So I am going to draw here. So one is like this. This is wrong, right? And one is like this. This is pitch, right? Another is like this. This is called yaw. So we are having three motions: roll, pitch, or yaw. So these will be controlled by three moments, right? Yawing moment, pitching moment, and rolling moment. So that we are going to see what are those. So first is pitching moment, denoted by capital M. So pitching moment, it is the moment acting in the plane containing lift and drag. So lift is here and drag is here, right? And pitch is happening about this, right? Like this. So pitching moment is the moment acting in the plane containing lift and drag, or it is happening in the perpendicular direction when viewed from the top, right? If you are viewing from the top, it will happen about the perpendicular direction when aircraft is flying horizontally, right? It is flying like this. The moment will be acting in vertical axis, about vertical axis, like this, right? So this is known as pitching. So in that case, what will happen? Your nose will go up and down, right? So that kind of things will happen, and it will be considered positive, right? Pitching moment will be considered positive if my nose of aircraft is going up, and it will be considered negative if nose is going down, right? Keep in mind. So pitching moment will be negative if my nose is going down, or nose is depressing down, and it is positive when nose is going up. This is the one pitching moment. If you're going for second one, that is called rolling moment. That is represented by L suffix R. So rolling moment is a moment which tends to make an aircraft to roll about the flight direction. So this is the flight direction. Alright, about that it will try to roll the aircraft. Or you can say it is a moment which will make one aircraft wing to depress while other to go up. So which wing will go down and which will go up, in that case I will get positive moment. If my right wing, that we used to say star mode. So right wing is also known as star mode position, star mode wing. And the left wing of aircraft is known as port wing, port, star mode and port wing. So if the moment causing the starboard wing going down and port wing to go up, right, that means your aircraft is rolling about right direction, right? This will be considered positive, right? And vice versa, if my rolling if my moment is making to depress, pole moving down and star moving up, that will be considered as negative rolling moment. Alright, so rolling moment is over.
Third one is yawing moment. Right, this will be represented by capital N.
So yawing moment, it is the moment tends to make an aircraft to swing to either side of the lift direction. So lift direction is this. So it is the moment which will make your aircraft to swing to either side of the lift direction, and it will be considered positive if it will be making the nose of the aircraft to swing to the right. If nose of the aircraft is going to the right, it will be considered positive moment. If nose is going to the left, it will be considered negative yawing moment. Keep in mind. So right side as swing will be considered positive, left side swing will be considered negative. Similarly for pitch, nose up moment will be considered positive pitching moment, nose down will be negative pitching moment. Similarly roll, right side rolling will be positive and left side rolling will be considered negative. So like that, these are the three moments acting on the aircraft and four basic forces: lift, weight, thrust and drag. Alright, always keep in mind if somebody is saying that steady state condition means all the four forces will be in equilibrium, right? None of them is going to change. There is accelerated flight, that means one or more of both basic forces will change in the magnitude, that will become higher or lower than the opposite force. In that case, it will be unaccelerated flight, right? So these are the aerodynamic forces and moments acting on the aircraft. Now let's go to discussion, because I mentioned the center of pressure, that also need to be discussed here. So let's start our discussion for center of pressure and aerodynamic center, because that is also very very important topic, basic fundamental topic before going in depth understanding of the lift and drag concept. So aerodynamic center and center of pressure,
as I said, that if we look at the airfoil, so airfoil will be something like this. This is the airfoil, and I can draw the chord length, the shortest horizontal line connecting trailing edge and leading edge. So this is my chord line, right? So one point is there over it from the leading edge. This position is called leading edge. This is known as, this tip is known as trailing edge, right? So there is one point right over the chord line behind leading edge, somewhere right where one moment will be acting, as you see, right? So this distance is known as XAC. X and distance, and this total from leading edge to trailing edge is known as chord length, right? Chord length. One position is this. Second position I am drawing here. Here another point is there. One aerodynamic center was here. So this is again, I will say, the second position XCP, where only lift and drag will be acting, right? And this is completely C. So this point is known as center of pressure, and this point is known as aerodynamic center. Now what are those? So aerodynamic center is a point on the chord line, it is a fixed point on the chord line behind the leading edge, about which pitching moment coefficient remains the same irrespective of the angle of attack. That means it is not going to change with the angle of attack. So there is no change on moment, pitching moment coefficient, while we are changing the angle of attack. That means at this point there will be undesirable pitching moment always acting, and we cannot prefer to have our lift aerodynamic force to be acting over this point, otherwise our aircraft will be unstable always, because there will be undesirable pitching moment which is acting on this point. So it is a fixed point on the chord line behind the leading edge, at which pitching moment coefficient remains
a constant irrespective of the angle of attack. So mathematically we can say DCM, CM is the pitching moment coefficient, AC aerodynamic center divided by D alpha is 0. It is not going to change with the angle of attack. So angle of attack will define it also. Later on I will prove this. So DCM AC divided by DCL, this is coefficient of lift, is also 0. That is also 0. It's not going to change with lift as well. So it is a fixed point, it's not going to vary. So if I'm changing angle of attack, nothing will happen to the point. So point is not going to move. So it will always be lying within the airfoil shape. So it will be built there. Second point is called center of pressure, right, which is here. So center of pressure is the point on the chord line behind leading edge at which the resulting aerodynamic force is supposed to act, or we can say it is the point behind the leading edge, right, on the chord line about which pitching moment is 0, right. So at this point my CM is 0, so pitching moment is 0, so all the aerodynamic phenomena will be represented only by lift and drag. Only lift and drag, there will be no undesirable force which would be acting over here. So this basically the point where we get the lift and drag. And when we are designing the aircraft wing, it should be attached in such a way that center of pressure should lie somewhere at this point, nearby this point. So as this point is moving in, because lift and drag basically varies with the angle of attack, right, varies with the flight velocity. So this point will not be a fixed point in the wing, right? It will vary and sometimes it may lie outside of the profile also. So it is not a fixed point, but aerodynamic center is a fixed point, right? Is that clear? There is a basic difference. So aerodynamic center is a fixed position, right? Behind the leading edge on the chord line, right? About which pitching moment coefficient is independent of the angle of attack, right? So there will be undesirable pitching moment always acting at this point, right? So we do not fix our aircraft wing at the aerodynamic center. Second is center of pressure. Center of pressure is the point at which net resultant aerodynamic force is supposed to act, or moment is 0, pitching moment is 0. So this is the perfect position, right, where your aircraft wing needs to be installed, right? It is a moving point, right, because lift varies with the angle of attack. So center of pressure will also move. So it will not be within the airfoil shape, right? Sometimes we will be top or bottom based on the angle of attack. That is the basic difference between center of pressure and aerodynamic center. So I think so for today, this much is enough. So today I have covered two topics. One is aerodynamic forces and movements acting on the aircraft. Second is aerodynamic center and center of pressure, right, what are those. And I hope you would have got the required, you know, ideas about these different forces, movement and center of pressure and aerodynamic center. Still, if you are having any doubts, feel free to ask me in the comment section. So thank you for listening to me. Have a nice day. Good day.